Hi everyone, I am here to continue reading The Jungle Book to you today, and today we're actually going to finish chapter 2. But stand still, little brother, or you will crush us with your feet. Mowgli stood still and quiet, peering through the open carvings of the summer house. The fight around Bagheera was awful and furious, when the Black Panther bucked and twisted under the throng of the monkeys. For the first time since he was born, Bagheera was fighting for his life. Mowgli was full of worry and remorse and desperately wanted to help his friend. "Roll to the water tanks and plunge in," Mowgli called, for he knew that the monkeys would not follow the panther into the water. Bagheera was exhausted and badly cut, but the sound of little Mowgli's voice filled him with hope. He began to inch his way toward the reservoir, fighting off the long-armed creatures as he did so. Then, from behind the city wall, rose the rumbling war cry of Baloo. Slipping and sliding up the terrace, he grabbed as many monkeys as he could and batted them hard with his paws. Splash! Bagheera had made it to the water tank and was, for the moment, safe. A horde of monkeys leaped and shouted furiously on the terrace nearby, but they did not go in the water. Mang the Bat carried the news of the battle over the jungle until Hathi, the wild elephant, trumpeted, alerting everyone for miles. Finally, Ka slithered straight into the mass of monkeys, anxious to do battle. Driving forward with his flat head, he lunged with the strength of a locomotive. "Ka, it's Ka, run!" shouted the monkeys in fear. Generations of stories had taught them to be deathly afraid of the monstrous python. To them, Ka was a terrifying creature who could slip along the branches as quietly as moss grows, steal off with the strongest monkey that ever lived, or make himself look so much like a rotten stump that even the wisest monkey was deceived until he was caught and strangled. Ka brought fear into the monkeys' hearts because none of them knew the limits of his power. None could look him in the eye, and none had ever survived his hug. Stammering with terror, they ran to the walls and roofs of the long deserted houses. Baloo heaved a sigh of relief as Bagheera climbed out of the water tank, shaking himself off. Mowgli did a little dance inside the summer house, being careful not to trample the snakes, and hooted like an owl. In the trees and houses, the monkeys shrieked in fear. But when Ka let out a long hiss, the Bandar log were silenced. "I think they have pulled me into 100 little bearlings," Baloo said gravely as he shook out his legs. "Ka, we owe you our lives, I think." "No matter," Ka replied. "Where is the manling?" "I am trapped in here," Mowgli cried from inside the summer house. "I can't climb out." Indeed, the curve of the broken dome was far above his head. Ka eyed the wall of the summer house carefully, searching for a crack. He tapped the weak spot lightly with his head. Lifting 6 feet of his body off the ground, he lunged forward with several massive blows, using his nose to break the carved screenwork, which fell to the ground in a cloud of dust and rubble. Mowgli flung himself at Baloo and Bagheera, throwing an arm around each large neck. "Are you hurt?" asked Baloo, hugging him tenderly. "I am sore, hungry, and bruised, but they have hurt both of you." "It is nothing if you are safe," Baloo said. "We shall discuss that later," said Bagheera in a serious voice. "Now, Mowgli, you must thank Ka according to our customs." Mowgli turned to the giant snake. "We be one of blood, you and I," he said. "I take my life from you tonight. My meal shall be your meal if ever you are hungry, O Ka." "All thanks, little brother," said Ka, his eyes twinkling. He was not sure that Mowgli could offer him enough food to fill his long belly, but he was impressed with the boy's courage. Your brave heart and courteous tongue shall carry you far in the jungle, manling. But now you should leave quickly with your friends, for the moon is setting and you should not see what is about to happen. Above them, the moon was sinking behind the hills, and the shadows of the trembling monkeys looked ragged and fringed. Kaa glided to the center of the terrace and snapped his jaw together, forcing the monkeys to look at him. "Now begins Ka's dance of the hunger," he said to the monkeys. "Sit still and watch, all of you." Ka began to move, weaving his head from left to right as he made circles on the terrace. Then he made loops and figure eights with his long body, and oozy triangles that melted into squares and five-sided figures, and coiled himself into mounds, never pausing or changing his pace, and singing a low humming song. He danced until the moonlight disappeared. Beside Mowgli, Bagheera, and Baloo stood still as stones, growling in their throats. Their neck hair stood on end. "Bandarlog," Ka shouted, "can you move without my order?" "We cannot, O Ka," the monkeys replied together. Indeed, they had been hypnotized by the python's dance. "Good," said Ka, "you must all come one step closer to me." The monkeys followed Ka's order, as did Baloo and Bagheera. Mowgli reached up and pulled his friends back. As soon as he touched them, the panther and the bear started as if waking from a deep sleep. "Closer," Ka ordered the monkeys. The Bandarlog stepped forward again. "Keep your hand on my shoulder," said Bagheera with a shiver, "or I will have to do as the snake says." "It is only Ka making circles in the dust," Mowgli said, as the three slipped away into the jungle. As a man cub, he had not been lured by the dance, and his nose was all sore. "His nose was sore because of you," Bagheera reminded him, "as my ears and sides and paws and Baloo's neck and shoulders are bitten. You have cost us heavily in time, wounds and hair, and most importantly, honor. Baloo and I had to call upon Ka for help, and we were both made foolish by Ka's hunger dance. All of this came, Mowgli, from your playing with the Bandarlog." "It is all true," said Mowgli, sorrowfully. "I did wrong, and both of you are wounded. I know that the law of the jungle says I must be punished." Bagheera raised a paw and gave Mowgli half a dozen love taps, which would have hardly awoken a young panther, but were serious blows for a young boy. But when it was over, and Mowgli jumped onto the panther's back and returned to his own jungle, sleeping soundly the whole way. That is the end of chapter 2. I hope you enjoyed it, and please respond to the discussion question I will post on Google Classroom.